नमस्सर्वेभ्यः वेलकम टू दिस यूनिक अहम ब्रह्मास्मि चैनल। अहम ब्रह्मास्मि चैनल इज अ मल्टीफेसेटेड वन फैसिलिटेटिंग वेरियस मोड्स टू नो मोर अबाउट अद्वैता। वी हैव ए वेबसाइट www.ahambrahmasmi.org, आल्सो अहम ब्रह्मास्मि यूट्यूब चैनल एंड आल्सो ट्विटर टू हेल्प द जिज्ञासुस फाइंड सॉल्यूशन टू देयर क्वेश्चंस एंड आल्सो लेक्चर्स फ्रॉम वेरियस विद्वान्स एंड आल्सो ज्ञानीस। टुडे इन दिस सीरीज वी आर एयरिंग ए लाइव सेशन बाय श्री हेचन एलएन सिम्हा, आल्सो नोन एज श्री लक्ष्मीश। Sri Lakshmishji hails from a traditionally orthodox family. He was given Vedic education at a very young age. Being academically brilliant, he holds an M.Tech degree from IIT Madras, and he was an automation researcher at IISc before starting his vibrant career. He was a disciple of Veda Brahmashri D.S. Subbaramaya at Bengaluru, who taught Vedanta to Mr. Lakshmisha traditionally. Sri Simha is now taking Vedanta classes and also conducting Krishna Yajurveda Parayana through online classes. He has given discourses on Advaita at various meets, including one on Sri Dakshinamurti Stotram at the Sringeri Math, Bengaluru. He is serving Vedanta Bharati as a trustee too. Now, I leave the session to Sri Lakshmi Sachi to continue his lecture. Namaskara.
Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha Harihi Om. Om Guru Brahma Guru Vishnu Guru Devo Maheshwaraha Guru Sakshat Param Brahma Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha. श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानामालयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादशङ्करं लोकशङ्करं शङ्कारूपेण मच्चित्तं पङ्कीकृतमभूद्यया किङ्करीयस्य सा माया शङ्कराचार्यमाश्रये। द नेक्स्ट् टू श्लोकास् आर् दि गुरुपरम्परास्तोत्र स्पेशलि फार् विद्यारण्यश्रीचरणाः। अविद्यारण्यकान्तारे भ्रमतां प्राणिनां सदा विद्यामार्गोपदेष्टारं विद्यारण्यगुरुं श्रये। विद्या विद्या विवेकेन पारं संसारवारिधेः प्रापयन्त्यनिशं भक्तान् तं विद्यारण्यमाश्रये। ओं विवेकिनं महाप्रज्ञं धैर्योदार्यक्षमानिधिं सदाभिनवपूर्वं तं विद्यातीर्थगुरुं भजे। भारतीकरुणापात्रं भारतीपदभूषणं भारतीपदमारूढं भारतीतीर्थमाश्रये। विद्याविनयसम्पन्नं वीतरागं विवेकिनं वन्दे वेदान्ततत्त्वज्ञं विधुशेखरभारतीं। चन्द्रशेखरयोगीन्द्रशिष्यस्यास्मद्गुरोः पदौ श्रितानां मोक्षदौ सुब्बरामार्यस्याश्रयाम्यहम्। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। थैंक यू शेषाद्रीजी, गौतमजी एंड अदर्स इन दि ग्रुप अहम ब्रह्मास्मि ग्रुप। इट्स एन इनोवेटिव ग्रुप दैट हैज बीन स्टार्टेड। दिस इज द फर्स्ट उपन्यास इन द सीरीज ऑफ उपन्यासास दैट्स गोइंग टू बी फोकसिंग ऑन कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशंस ऑफ विद्यारण्य इन द आध्यात्मिक डोमेन। I have chosen to speak about Vidyaranya's contributions in a manner which is called Jnani and his Vyavahara. Jnani and his Vyavahara the topic has been chosen and the content will be structured in such a way that we are going to take the excerpts from Vidyaranya Sricharana's own expressions in his works like Viveka, Jeevan Mukti Viveka, Panchadashi, etc. And any relevant similarities or alignments with the works that are done by Sri Shankara Bhagavat Pujya Padacharya in the Brahma Sutra Bhashya, I'll bring it to that context. While doing so, the topic is itself quite deep. So I have to use some expressions that are there in the Bhashyas that are written by Vidyaranya Sricharanaha and the Stotras and Shlokas. It might have a lot of content in Sanskrita and Paribhashika Shabdas. This is a part of the design of the structure of the talk. Before I speak about Jnani and his Vyavahara, is this not a paradox? Jnani and Vyavahara? It is emphatically declared, Namumukshurna Vai Mukta Ityesha Paramarthata. Then what is this Vyavahara of a Jnani and what am I going to speak about? Ask ourselves the question, from whose standpoint? What do you mean by whose standpoint? From a Ajnani standpoint, that is a worldly standpoint, or from a Jnani standpoint? This brief presentation of today attempts to collate some of the deep thoughts expressed by Sri Vidyaranya Sricharanaha himself and, if necessary, other illustrious Jnanis, what have they said, as if in an answer to the question, and removing the so-called paradox in Jnani's Vyavahara, which arise in the minds of the seekers, Jignyasus or Mumukshus. Before we speak about the Jnani's Vyavahara, we have to understand a term here called Mithya at the very basis of all of these things. Mithyatvam, I need to only dwell on that particular aspect of Vedanta or Paribhasha in order to give a foundation for the rest of the talk. If you look at Mithyatvam as the Shabda for which we have to give a Vyutpatti or Lakshana, I have several of them, many different ways. One is absolutely highly deep formal definitions. Some are a little bit informal definitions. I'm going to roll out these things because they are going to be at the back of your mind when you hear the term Vyavahara. Brahma Bhinnam Sarvam Mithya is what is said. Brahma Bhinnasya Sakala Prapanchasya Mithyatva Siddhihi is what has been said in Vedanta Paribhasha in one occasion. That's one Lakshana. The second is Mithyatvancha, it's a bit technical. Sva Ashrayatvena Abhimata Yavannishtha Atyantabhava Pratyogitvam. This is the second definition. Don't get kind of hazled by or overawed by the Sanskrit part of it. It's going to be all in English subsequently. Then the third is Mithya is Avidya Pratyupasthapitam, is the nature of Mithyatva. The fourth very important aspect of Mithya or Mithyatvam is Jnana Nivartyatvam. Mithya is another paryaya for Ajnana. Ajnana is removed by Jnana. Jnana Nivartyatvam Mithyatva. Next, another technical definition. Pratipannopadhau Traikalika Nishedha Pratyogitvam Mithyatvam. Pratipannopadhau means it should be present, it should be experienced, but the underlying phenomenon or the truth behind it is not experienced. There's something that's superimposed on the Adhishthana. That is experience. That is called Mithya, not Atyanta Asat, like Vandhyaputra. That is not termed as Mithya here. Then, if it is present at one time and it's not present at another time, Adau Ante Chayan Nasti Vartamanepi Tat Tatha Isakarika. Though if it is not there in any one of the three states of time, past, present and future, then it is not Tat Satya. Therefore, that is Mithya. Then, Avicharita Samsiddham is a general term for Mithyatvam. They say Jagat Lokaha is Mithya. Where has that been said? Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahma Iva Naparaha. All of this that belongs to the Kshetra Koti is Mithya. Some synonyms for paryaya for mithya is brisha, alikatvam, maikatvam. What is maya? Ya, ma, sa, maya. So it comes under that category. Finally, what really is mithyatvam is anirvachaniyatvam. We should be careful in understanding anirvachaniyatvam because it is sat, asat, sadasat, vilakshanatvam can be used for Brahman also. But here mithyatvam is anirvachaniyatvam. Most careful. Here, the concept of a jnani in this vyavahara may now be kind of understood as the entire shastras are founded on one hypothesis. Hypothesis is an assumption that the seeker accepts adhyasa or ajnana as present. Only after accepting adhyasa or ajnana can we go ahead with the next step of vichara. Otherwise, entire amount of shastras, the advaita vichara is only targeted towards a jnani, not a realized one. For a jnani, he doesn't have to come to class. He is already passed the exam. He is graduated. He doesn't have to come and sit in the 10th standard again. So the seeker accepts a jnana or adhyasa either in one of the three states: absolute satyatvam, or empirical satyatvam, or apparent satyatvam. You know the technical terms for that. And also that ajnana can be destroyed by jnana. So these are all from the standpoint of a seeker who is not yet realized, as I said. In an absolute standpoint or a jnani's own standpoint, there is no mumukshu, there are no shastras, there is no moksha, there is not even the universe, which is paramarthikatvena sat. On accepting that there is adhyaya, therefore, it is called Abhyupetyavada. Shastra, what does it do? It doesn't talk about Srishti in order to delineate Srishti. Taittiriya Upanishad, Brahma Vida Apnoti Param. Then, Tat Srishtva, then all of these things, Akasha, Vayuhu, Vayu, Ragni, Agne, Rapaha, all of these things are meant to not point towards Srishti as the Tatpariya, but it's pointed towards Srashta. The Srashta is the point that we are wanting to highlight when the Shruti talks about Srishti. Therefore, there is no mumukshu in Paramarthika Satta. And as I said, there is no universe. So what is it that we are talking about? On accepting that there is adhyasa superimposition, which is termed as ajnana in general, one accepts all the things that follow. What are the first thing that follow is janma. We have got a body. This body has come out of a birth. Birth. What is the nimitta karma? What is the trigger for this birth? Our own punya and papa, which is taken or fructified as prarabdha. Therefore, that karma has come because of kama. Kama has come because of adhyasa or ajnana. All of these things are causative factors for what is called prarabdha karma. Prarabdha karma has begun to fructify and is therefore responsible for the present body, present mind, present intellect, which are necessary to realize that we are not attached permanently to the body, mind and intellect. Manushya Janma has been given, this is a thing in the Viveka Chudamani that we are just doing. Durlabham trayame vaitate, or Janma of Manushya Janma is Durlabham. And of course, Tataha, Viprata, etc. etc. But most important thing is Manushya Janma has been given because we have got sufficient amount of punya, of course, coupled with papa, because Manushya Janma has got a mixture, Mishra. And it is the most suitable for realizing Atmaswarupa Sakshatkara. What is it that the Shruti says, which are the best suitable places for attaining Brahmatmaikya Jnana that leads to moksha, points to moksha? There is one is Manushya Janma, other is Janma in Brahmaloka. All others are not so clear. I'm not going to go into that Viveka Chudamani part of it right now. I'm going to go further into the Jnani's part covering. There is a certain thing that the Ajnani undergoes, that is called Avarana and Vikshepa. Avarana is that which is called covering, that which covers the Swarupa apparently. The two of these, they are called Avarana Shakti and Vikshepa Shakti. Avarana Shakti is destroyed by jnana. But there is vikshepa shakti. Vikshepa shakti is also supposed to have two shades. One of them, it shows that there is apparent universe which is real. And that's called empirically real, vyavaharika satta. There is another aspect of vikshepa shakti that gives rise to what is called badhita anuvritti. Badhita anuvritti is similar to a person who is seeing a cloth that is burnt. Let's say, assume that there's a dark cloth, black cloth that's been burnt completely. There's no breeze to scatter the ashes. The black ash is still there, but you can still see the shades of the almost like thread looking like a cloth, but it doesn't have substance. If you touch it, it's all ash, powder. It's called dantapatanyayena. That's called apparent perception, and the jnani knows that it is not real. So the universe has seen these things, the apparent perception of the universe, as seen in this example of a burnt cloth appearing like a real cloth, is still not annihilated. That is what is called badhita anuvritti. Upon exhausting the prarabdha karma, which is the cause of this birth, Shruti says one attains videha mukti. Of course, there are theories that says there is only one birth. This is the last birth, like Vamadeva, etc. Or there can be more than one birth. That's a part of one prarabdha. We're not going to debate on that. So jnani abides in Brahman after he has exhausted the fructified prarabdha. And Shruti accepts prarabdha. What if you don't accept prarabdha? You say that jnani is not connected with the body, but then you say that there is prarabdha for it. If you don't accept prarabdha, what is the consequence? Apatti. There is a term called jivan mukti. Jivan mukti is a person who is embodied is a jnani. If you don't accept that there is a jnani with a body, if you don't accept that, then the negative consequence of that is there is no jnani parampara. Avichinna parampara of jnani to shishya, jnani to shishya. That is not possible at all. You can't have a jnani in the body. That is not so. So Shruti accepts, our parampara accepts, our sampradaya accepts, jivan mukta parampara. Therefore, what is now necessary to understand is, how do you attribute action, vyavahara, to this so-called jnani, apparently connected with the body from a jnani's perspective? That's the topic of discussion. By Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha, in his inimitable style, what is being spoken about is, he defines the last four stages of Saptabhumika as in Yoga Vasishta, in Yoga Shastra, and it says, Brahmavit, Brahmavid Varaha, Brahmavid Variyan, and Brahmavid Varishta. There are four differences that they make. The apparent contradiction between the two statements saying, the liberated will not have perception, see, the liberated sees not. And the other part of the discussion is that he takes part in activity. These are contradictory. But it's not contradictory if you analyze the Shruti and look at the Ekavakyata that comes and resolves these two in one direction, saying that is Adhyasika Sambandha. That means it's superimposition. It is resolved by cognizing the various degrees of what is called self-abidance or Vishranti Taratamya, as Shruti itself says. Vishranti Taratamya is expressed as the lingering aspect of Vikshepa Shakti and Prarabdha Karma, which come in the way of fully experiencing the bliss of liberation in spite of the Atmajnana, the direct realization. This is accepted by Shruti as a theory. This is from an Ajnani standpoint only, because he has to justify a Jivan Mukta. For a Mukta, there is no connection with the body at all. Even this is from a worldly standpoint. So for all external appearances of the perspective of an unrealized person, there is not the slightest difference between a fully ignorant person and a fully enlightened jnani. Why? Because it's not the body that is the thing that is supposed to be seen. It is the Atma Swarupa that's the difference. So in the activity or the absence of activity, they appear the same. The body, the mind, the intellect. Sometimes the Jivan Mukta has got kopa. Sometimes he feels happy. He goes through snana, achamana, bhiksha, etc. What's the big difference? So in the panchadashi, Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha himself says, pravrittavva nivrittavva dehendriyamanodhiyam na kinchidapi vaishamyam asti ajnani vibuddhayoho. Between these two, ajnani and vibuddha, you cannot identify physical changes. There are sthita prajna lakshanas that are there in dvitiya adhyaya of Bhagavad Gita. Those are given as sthita prajna lakshanas, not to have a checklist of quality checklist of saying, if you have this, if you have this, if you have this, then you are a sthita prajna. No, it is meant for us to imbibe those qualities in ourselves. That is sarvatraiva hi adhyatma shastre kritartha lakshanani yani tanyeva sadhanani upadishyante yatna sadhyatvat. That is the maxim that is used. So the phases of a jnani's life evokes different kind of reactions from people, various impressions they gather. Why? People judge a jnani so differently, depending on their bank balances, their perspective. What is it that they have to judge? Thus, the enlightened are not alike from a worldly standpoint, again. But he's totally indifferent to what others think. If somebody thinks something of him, will he change? Not at all. So he got udasinya. The state of vidvad anubhava of a jnani is one on reaching which one finds that he has with him the substance of all desires, substance meaning the truth of all desires and attainments all at once. Where has that been said? In the Taittiriya Upanishad, there can be many. In Taittiriya Upanishad, we remember, so oshnute sarvan kama ansaha. Therefore, there is nothing that is left to be desired. There is no object of desire that is different from himself. That's what the jnani feels. Sarvam kalvidam brahma. The state of a jnani experiencing this, which is real vidyananda or atmananda, is referred to in four ways as he defines, Vidyaranya himself defines. Dukkha bhavascha kamaptihi krita krityo ahamityasau prapta prapyo ahamityevam chaturvidhyam udahritam. In the Panchadashi, in the 14th chapter, 3rd shloka, Bhagavat Padacharyaha, we must remember, he is the preceptor of Sri Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha, and has great, Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha has great respect. He provides that kind of a feeling all over. Shankara Bhagavat Padacharyaha says in the Viveka Chudamani that the various opinions showed by the ignorant people about jnanis, he himself was a jnani par excellence, he says, some people think that he, the enlightened one, appears sometimes as an ignorant, sometimes like a learned one, sometimes possessed of regal splendor, or as innocent children or a child, sometimes as a madman, sometimes very cordial, evoking respect, sometimes even being insulted. But one thing that is common is nobody can fathom the depth or the way or the state of a realized man. And some of the people, even like people like Umesh, when referring to our Sadguru Shishubramaya Charanaha, he said, I am in awe at the state in which you are. He, some of the statements that he has said that I have recorded. So he enjoys always immersed in supreme bliss. In respect of him, referred to as Yogi Paramahamsa, Acharya quotes in the Smriti, Acharya quotes the Smriti in the Jivan Mukti Viveka, in the 5th shloka, Darshana Darshane Hitva Swayam Tu Swayam Kevala Rupataha Yastishthati Satu Brahman Brahma Na Brahmavit Swayam. I'll explain what the meaning of this in summary. He who is established in oneself, taking no heed of perception or non-perception, is, O Brahmana, here Satu Brahman is a reference to Sambodhana, O Brahmana, he is not just a knower of Brahman, but is Brahman himself, embodied himself, Swarupa, Brahma Swarupa, not Brahma Jnana. As Bhagavan Sri Krishna, we must remember how they are in alignment with the Shruti, the Smriti, and also Vidvad Anubhava. I'm bringing out these aspects because what Sri Vidyarana Sri Charana has written is in 100% alignment with the Ekavakyata, that's the Tatparya of the Shrutis. It says, Jnani is one who has transcended all opposites. Opposites? Yes. Avibhaktam cha bhuteshu vibhaktam iva cha sthitam iva is the secret out there. The diversity of the universe is just apparent and arise due to ajnana, ignorance. The jnani is ever conscious of the underlying unity in diversity, even when he apparently is performing tasks. I'll come to some experience expressions in this. Also, as in Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmane Gavihastini Shunichai Vashvapakecha Pandita Samadarshinaha Vihai Vatair Jitas Sargo. Important. Yesham Samye Sthitam Manaha Nirdosham Hi Samam Brahma Tasmad Brahmanite Sthitah. In the Gita, 5th chapter, 18th and 19th shloka, here Samam is a Paryayapada for Brahman, Brahma Swarupa. A jnani is one who perceives equality or sameness, samatva, in all beings as constituted of the same material. If I may use the term material, like Brahman. The most strikingly emphatic expression to a jnani's point of view is rendered by Sri Shankara Bhagavad Padaha in the Sutra Bhashya, in the Prasthanatraya, 4th Adhyaya, 1st Pada, 13th Sutra, it says in the commentary, Purva Siddha Kartritva Bhoktritva Viparitam Hi Trishvapi Kaleshu Akartritva Abhoktritva Swarupam Brahma Ahamasmi Netav Purvamapi Karta Bhoktava Ahamasam Medani Napi Bhavishyat Kale Iti Brahmavit Avagachati. Such a bold statement coming from a lion. Quite opposite to what had been previously regarded as I am the enjoyer, I am the doer, I am an agent of karma. Opposite to that, it says, I am verily that Brahman, which by nature is neither a doer nor enjoyer at all three segments of time. Even earlier, that is before, if we use the term P0, at the time when he attained Sakshatkara, I was never before a doer or an enjoyer. That's what is the crux of what is this Anubhava is. I was always a Mukta. Nor am I at present, after that term called Jivan Sakshatkara has happened. Nor shall I be so for all time to come in the future. That's what is a Vidvad Anubhava, Jnani Anubhava. Therefore, how can you associate Vyavahara with such a Jnani? So, the knower of Brahman, earlier in the commentary for Brahma Sutras, has been defined in this manner as Brahma Atma Aikya Jnani Anubhava. He alludes to the state of a Jnani as Sthita Prajna. Tasmat Mithyatva Pratyaya Nimittatvat Shariratvasya Shariratvam is Mithya Pratyaya. It's coming from Ajnana. Therefore, Siddham Jivatopi Vidushaha Ashariratvam. Even when person is looking embodied in a body, if he is a Jivan Mukta, Jivatopi Vidushaha Ashariratvam Mokshakyam Nityam Iti Siddham is Bhagavad Pada's commentary. Vidushaha Sarva Pravritti Asambandhancha Darshayati. There is no Pravritti at all for a person who is a Jivan Mukta. Again, paradox, how can you associate Vyavahara to such person? It's from a standpoint of an Ajnani. But there is a way out. Tasmat, if you are not a realized person, na avagata brahmasya bha, tasmat, na avagata brahmatma bhavasya, yathapurvam samsaritvam. Yathapurvam samsaritvam means just like before, you will not have that samsaritva if you have attained brahmatmaikya jnana. Yasyatu yathapurvam samsaritvam na asau avagata brahmatma bhavaha iti anavadyam. That means that doesn't have dosha. This is Brahma Sutra Bhashya. It's in the Samanmaya Adhikarana 1144. Therefore, for the one who is enlightened, a jnani, there is no more samsara from a paramarthic standpoint as before. As for one who has samsara as before, he has not realized brahmatma ki jnana. That is clear. As there is no distraction for a jnani, the practice of samadhi is also not necessary. This is what Vidyarana Svitranaha is going to say now. Therefore, why the distraction and therefore the samadhi, whom is this for? For a person who is attached to the mind, who has got the granthi, with chidachit granthi, and who is subject to the constant fluctuations. And this is said beautifully in the Panchadashi. In the Panchadashi, it says,
Vikshepo nasti yasman me na samadhistato mama vikshepo va samadhirva manasaha syat vikarinaha.
Not for me. From a jnani standpoint, this is from Panchadashi 6th, the 7th chapter 265. From a jnani's viewpoint, he does not desire sleep. He doesn't really, in his jnani's perspective, he is not going to beg for food, no bathing, no purification necessary, because he doesn't have an attachment to aham mama abhimana in the body. In as before, kama krodha purita vyavahara is not there for him. These activities are attributed by other worldly ignorant persons and does just not concern him at all.
Nidra bhikshe snana chaushnana shauche nechami nakaromi cha drashtarashchet kalpayanti kim me syad anya kalpanat.
If a dog barks outside, why should I be perturbed about it? That's what he says so emphatically in the Panchadashi. This is consistent with, as I said, Shankara Bhagavat Pujya Padacharya's own experience in the and expression in Viveka Chudamani, 554th shloka, that says,
Lakshya Lakshya Gatim Tyaktva Yastishthati Kevalatmana Shiva Eva Swayam Sakshat Ayam Brahmavid Uttamaha.
Abiding that in that person who is abiding in Brahman alone, he is a Brahmavita, he is Jnani, and he is verily Shiva himself, nothing other than that. Sri Vidyarana Charana completely concurs in the above concept and declares,
Vikshepo yasya nastyasya brahmavitvan namanyate brahmaivayam iti prahu na munayaha paradarshinaha.
This is in Panchadashi again in the 4th chapter. He says, these are the Jivan Muktas. They are not Brahmavit as knower of Brahman, but Brahman themselves. It is only by courtesy one who has a transcendent vikshepas is referred to as the Brahmavit, knowers of truth. The munis declare that he is Brahman himself. Also says the Manisha Panchaka. It's a beautiful statement that I got from the Manisha Panchaka. It says,
Yasmin nitya sukham budhau galitadhir brahmaiva na brahmavit.
Good to remember that statement. It says that jnani is really Brahman himself. He emphatically declares that the jnani is untouched by avidya or its products. What are these products?
Kama, karma, and what have you?
And these are burnt to smithereens, burnt to ashes by aparoksha brahmatmaikya jnana. In his own words, Vidyarana Sri Charanaha also concurs in that and says,
Jivan akurna marjaram hanti hanyat katham mritaha.
A rat, even while alive, cannot kill a cat. Can a dead rat kill a cat? Never. So jnani does not have chyuti or does not get dislodged from the Brahman consciousness even for a split second. How can you have a vyavahara for such a person? Says in the Aparokshanubhuti, but he has written a commentary on that also. So it says in the Aparokshanubhuti, the original, it says,
Nimeshardhannatishthanti vrittim brahmamayim vina yathatishthanti brahmadyaha sanakadyaha shukadayaha.
Brahma is the Chaturmukha Brahma here. So Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha writes in the Aparokshanubhuti Tika, his commentary on the Aparokshanubhuti, it says,
Iti sampradayo darshitaha he says that this the lineage has accepted this. He hints that Brahman Atman experience continues to himself through the lineage coming from Ishvara, from Bhagavad Shankara Bhagavad Pujyapadataha to myself and to the lineage of jnanis to follow. That is why we say avichinna jivan mukti parampara in Sringeri Sharada Peetham, for instance, and there are many like that. Thus, all along the Guru Shishya Parampara, the master disciple lineage, it is the same. Same means one swarupa, spurana swarupa among apparently different jnanis. Sri Shankara Bhagavad Padacharya brings it beautifully in the Shatashloki. And Shatashloki says, it's good to remember what kind of an expression comes with jnanis. Drishtanto naiva drishtaha tribhuvana jathare sadguror jnanadatuhu sparshaschet tatra kalpyaha sa nayati yadaho swarnatam ashmasaram na sparshatvam tathapi shrita charana yuge sadguru sviya shishye sviyam samyam vidhatte bhavati nirupamaha tenava alaukikopi. The Sadguru, Brahmajnani, is not like equivalent of a philosopher's stone, touchstone. What does it do? It makes anything that it touches, converts that into gold. But it falls short of what a guru does. A philosopher's stone does not touch another entity and makes it another philosopher's stone, whereas a guru makes another shishya as a guru himself. He gives his own self, true identity. That is Brahman, Brahmatvam to the shishya. Therefore, there is no living simile at all. Thus a jnani has nothing to gain actually, because nothing for upadeyam. He doesn't have anything to give up also. Aheya anupadeya. But still there is a guru shishya parampara where he has utmost compassion to the shishya. Ko guruhu, as Shankara Bhagavad Pada has said, adhigata tattvaha. That's not enough. It's necessary. It's not sufficient. It says, shishya hitaya udyata satatam. Both these together makes that person a guru. Therefore, he has a lot of compassion to give to the shishya who comes with a proper orientation. It's really the orientation of shishya that actually gets reflected in the kripa that is going to flow all the time from the guru. In his own words, again, it says, yavaharo laukikova shastriyova anyathapiva mama akartu alepasya yatha arabdham pravartatam. Now coming to vyavahara. Athava krita krityopi lokanugraha kamyaya. That is where yena ayam natanena. Natanena means what? A person who wants to go onto a stage as I am Krishna. The child boy knows that he is for a limited time of half an hour, he is going to enact his role as a Krishna. He knows he is not. Ishvara also takes this form and comes down as a manushya, as in front of us like a guru. And yenayam natanena atra budhyate karyameva tate. So you have to take that, all of these things that is going to come in the vyavahara as for agnya prabodhat naiva anyat karyam asti atra tadvidaha anya prabodhat means shishya prabodhat, for us to give jnana. Ishvara has taken the form and come to us in order to give us jnana and take us from the bonds of samsara to liberation. A jnani's actions, as seen from a worldly standpoint, you can see those actions there are solely directed towards lokanukraha and guiding the shishyas towards that light. Brahmatmaikya jnana. Acharya is another term that is used for a guru and a jnani and a jivan mukta. No price for remembering what the yutpatti for lakshana for acharya is. Achinotihi shastranam achinotihi shastrartham achare sthapayatyapi swayamacharate yasmad acharya uchyate. I might have missed one small portion out there, but that's the term there. Therefore, it's a lokanugraha that's bind them towards this, and it's meant for us. It's not for the jnani. Jnani conforms to the dictates of the Shruti, and as per the remnants of prarabdha that is still lingering, that is from a worldly standpoint. We have read some fortunate ones that actually had direct experience with some jivan muktas in our own lives. So we know how Ajnani's Vyavahara will be in the lives of, in the Puranas and the Shrutis, in Yajnavalkya, Bhagavan Vyasa himself, Sri Shankara Bhagavat Pujya Padacharyaha, Sri Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha, Sri Chandrasekhara Bharati Mahaswaminaha, Jagatgurus adorning the Peetham at Sringeri until then, from today, right now, Sarati Bhuvane Shankaracharya Rupa, Sri Bharati Tirtha Mahaswaminaha, Sri Sri Vidushekara Bharati Sannidhanam, and our Reverend Sadguru, Vidyaguru, Sri Sri Shankara Bharati Swaminaha, and our Vedanta Sadguru, Sri Veda Brahma Sri Subramanya Garu, who all showed utmost compassion in spreading the message of the Upanishads. Brahma Satyam Jagan Mithya Jivo Brahmaiva Na Aparaha, and dispelling by stage, step by step, Ajnana that the Shishya has got. So from Ajnani's viewpoint, what comes out, it's brought out very clearly once again, as in Shastraihi Prakriya Bhedaihi Avidya Eva Upavarnyate Brahma Drishtya Tu Avidya Iyam Nat Kathanchana Yujyate. All Shastras, even Brahmatmaikya Jnana Vichara Purvaka Shastra, is founded on communicating to Avidya itself is being spoken about there, not Atmaswarupa. It doesn't show with a Shringa Grahika Nyaya. Shruti also does not hold on to Atmaswarupa and say, here, this is the Lakshana of Atmaswarupa. It does not say so. As Shastras propound their theories based on a hypothesis, this is called Abhyupetya Vada. Bhedam Anudya Abhedam Upadishati Shastram. They all describe Avidya in various depths. However, it is certain that, what is certain? From a Brahmatmaikya Jnani's viewpoint, from his perspective, if you can say there is a perspective, this Avidya simply cannot be established by Pramana. Pramana cannot establish something that is not there. Ya, Ma, Saha, Maya, it can only go with Pramana, it actually goes. Therefore, the worldly ignorant people mistake the appearance of the body of the Jnanis, and the body that the Jnani possesses apparently, but not knowing the truth of it, because they are in delusion. Even though the Jnani abides in Brahman and is wholly rid of the bondages of the body and the world, where does it say that? Jivatopi Vishuddha Vidushaha Ashariratvam Mokshakhyam Nityam Iti Siddham, as in the Viveka Chudamani 548 and 549. Tadvad Dehadi Bandhebhyo Vimuktam Brahmavittamam Pashyanti Dehavat Modha Dehavin Modhaha Sharirabhasa Darshanat. Vivek Shudamani 548, 549. It may not be out of place to quote a recent episode, not very far away in back in time, that of Sri Chandrasekhar Bharati Mahaswami. Maybe some of us in the audience would have actually had darshan of Chandrasekhar Bharati Mahaswami. I was born less than a year after Videha Mukti of Chandrasekhar Bharati Mahaswaminaha. That was in 54 in Chandrasekhar Bharati Mahaswaminaha. So the Peethadhipati of Dakshinamurti Sri Sringeri Sharada Peetha was widely recognized and respected to be a Jivan Mukta even in those days. Once a sadhaka from Bengal came to seek an answer to his doubt as to how Jnani's Vyavahara, Jivan Mukta, can be involved in action. Is it so? Karma. So he had visited so many places in the north and had not got a satisfactory explanation. He was advised, please go to Sringeri and seek the guidance of His Holiness Sri Chandrasekhara Bharati Mahaswamigal. He came and posed this doubt to His Holiness. I'll reflect the dialogue. It has been already published in many books. It says, His Holiness, he says, what have you seen? Have you seen a Jivan Mukta doing karma? Disciple, I just saw your holiness doing puja. Holiness, what did you see? Disciple, your holiness doing engaged in puja, Swamiji. His holiness, what did you see? Your holiness doing puja. Then his holiness said, think about it. Come back, really analyze what exactly is the content of your sight. Come back to me next day. The next day he went, the dialogue took place and he was told to think again and come back. After serious introspection, he got the answer to his doubt that he's not seeing the Jivan Mukta doing anything. He's seeing the limbs of the body involved in action. That is what he saw. He then prostrated to His Holiness and for resolving his doubt. Among all the Jnanis and Jivan Muktas of the highest order, Sri Sri Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha stands prominent. He had the sole purpose of not only giving Jnana and bless the seekers, but also establish the famous Vijayanagara Empire. Call it Vyavahara. This is in the 14th century AD, which even today astonishes everyone who visits or even reads about the splendor and the grandeur surrounding it. We all have it in recent history that Jnanis have no conflict, no contradiction, even with empirical parlance, like establishing and running an empire like a Vijayanagara empire. This is exemplified by the lives of Jnanis like Janaka, Sri Rama, Sri Krishna, and Sri Sri Vidyaranya Charanaha himself, who confidently proclaims from his own direct experience, Tadittham tattva vijnane sadhananupavardhanat jnanina charitam shakyam samyag rajyadi laukikam. Panchadashi, 9th chapter, 114th shloka. All these expressions made in this presentation, brief presentation, are from the standpoint of a worldly person, an Ajnani's perspective or a Sadhaka's perspective, while the Supreme Jnani is unaffected by all our adhyasa, superimpositions about him. For him, as the Karika says, Namu mukshur navai mukta ityesha paramarthata. It is clear that there is no contradiction, let there be no paradox from a standpoint of a Jnani. All apparent paradoxes are removed and there is no contradiction whatsoever from the viewpoint of a Jnani. Therefore, Sadguru Charanaravinda Arpanamastu Om Tat. Here, it is necessary to remember the stotra that everybody in Sringeri recites. I must end my presentation with a stotra that was composed by my own great-grandmother, Achammanni we used to call. She was the one who composed the original of what is being spoken or chanted all over the world, including at Sringeri. Mangalam Guru Shri Chandra Mauleshwara Ge Shakti Ganapati Sharadambege Shankracharyarige. And then subsequently, Vidyaranyarige Vidya Shankrarige Vagishwari Varavajra Deha Garudanjaneyarige. I've skipped some because of paucity of time. This was actually composed by my great-grandmother, my mother's father's mother. Therefore, this is chanted by all devotees today at Sringeri Sharada Peetham and all over the world. Must remember Vidyaranya in this context. And I must end my small presentation. I might have crossed by 10 minutes. For giving me an opportunity to take all the words from Shankara Bhagavatpada Acharyaha and Sri Vidyachandra Charanaha themselves and offer it back at the lotus feet of their holinesses. In the Saundarya Lahari, it says that all the things that I have taken are walk from yourself. I'm offering at your lotus feet. That is that same thing that I'm doing. And I offer my humble pranams to Vidyaranya Sri Charanaha and pray to him that I may be given the direction and kripa that liberates me and put the last step towards achieving the sarthakatva for this janma. Namaste. Sadguru Charanaravinda Arpanamastu Om Tat Sat.
Thank you for the wonderful talk, Sri Simhaji. We wish to go on for a few more minutes, but we have to cut it short. There are a couple of questions from the audience. A question is, Mr. Ashok Bharadwaj wants to know anecdotes connected with Jnanis presently. If you're aware of any anecdotes.
Can you repeat that once again? There was a blank in between.
Mr. Ashok wants to know anecdotes, any anecdotes of present day Jnanis you might have come across.
Yes.
One of the expressions that I can give is about something that is very personal, because that is something that I can hold as authentic information. One is that there is an expression given to in the book that is titled as Dakshinamurti Stotram, a commentary based on Manasolasa, that's authored by my Sadguru, Vidya Guru, Sri Subbaramaya Garu, Veda Brahma Sri Subbaramayaha. In that, there is a Sri Mukha, that is a preface, which is written by none other than Jivan Mukta par excellence, Srimad Abhinava Vidya Tirtha Mahaswaminaha Pratasmaraniyaha. In the Sanskrit definition, Sanskrit write-up, in that it says, about Subbaramaya, he says that he has attained that jnana, anubhavam sampadya, anubhutim sampadya. And he has said that directly to our Guru Guru, Sri Subbaramaya Garu, when he used to meet him very often. They were about the same age. Therefore, there is about 13 or 14 years of constant patha that we had with Subbaramaya Garu. And that is one episode that I can say about Srimad Abhinav Vidyatirtha Mahaswaminaha giving a stamp of recognition for our Guruji, and therefore he is a Jivan Mukta. Chandrasekhara Bharati Mahaswaminaha, and people, those who have seen them, have got innumerable. Then Sadashiva Brahmendraha, there is no doubt at all in nobody's mind about his being in a state of constant bliss. Anecdotes are aplenty. Chandrasekhara Bharati Mahaswaminaha, at one point in time, he actually was writing Viveka Chudamani, and then he stopped somewhere before the last few shlokas, and he said, from then onwards, I'm going to remain in my state of Ananda Anubhava. And he has actually not written the last few commentaries to the last few shlokas themselves. Everybody in the whole world recognizes that this particular person was this jnani, and that is Avatara Purusha. There are many such people around us, in and around us. I don't know if I may say similar experiences are there from my mother's standpoint also. My mother himself was spoken to by Abhinav Vidyatirtha Mahaswaminaha and says, Nimige Avarana Illa. That Avarana Shakti Nimigilla is a recognition that has been given to my mother. And she used to be very, very close to me. I cannot say, it cannot be more authentic. And I have referred to Jnani's perspective or viewpoint of these people. Therefore, there are some of the episodes. They would look at an object that looks at outside as a reflection of one's own consciousness. Anecdote, you are asking. Expressions in my mother's words are, everything that is around me is my album, photo album or video album, if you may call. That is the kind of expression that they have. And our Subbaramaya Garu's expression is, Aham Shishya Vada Bhami. I am the one who is appearing like a Shishya. That is the expression that they used to show. I don't know if there are many, many, many more episodes. I don't know if there is time for doing all this. These are some of the things that indicate their exalted state. In passing, I mentioned that there is a comment that Sri Umesh Ji had spoken about our Guru, Sadguru Sri Subbaramaya Garu, and said, I am at awe when I look at the state or exalted state of Brahma Sakshatkara that you are in, Sahaja Samadhi. He has written that. He would not have said that just like that for praising somebody. These are some of the anecdotes.
Thank you, sir. Another question. Hosadagi Adhyatmika Prapanchakke Kalitiruva Shishugalu Nima Ivatina Pravachanavannu Ondu Kattakadeya Mailigallu Endu Pariganisabeke.
A good question. This is actually a starting point. Kattakade Mailugallu is like the Paryavasana. That's the end point. There is no further growth going beyond that. Instead of looking at it outside, turn the whole direction inside. Pratyak. Pratyak Pravanata means what? Instead of looking outside, if you look inside, there can be only up to some point that then you can go inside, beyond which you cannot go inside. How far is the Paryavasana? What is the limit? What is the so-called limit of reaching this, going inside and inside and inside, being Swarupa oneself? That is called Maili Gallu. That is the ultimate target. Maili Gallu means milestones as I go towards the target. There are graduations. Graduations means To go from here to Mysore, you go to Mandya, there is a milestone, there is then you go to Chiriyampatna, etc., etc. Therefore, you recognize that as your Chitta Shuddhi increases day by day, which from the perspective of Guru's views and your own understanding of how your attachment is getting loosened from daily afflictions, you can know that you are progressing in the path of sadhana. So my perspective is, vyavahara has to be taken as a part of what we are engaged in because of prarabdha karma, but sublimated. Sublimated means what? Turn it towards atma jnana sakshatkara, to attain sadhana for atma sakshatkara. Then it can be used that jnani's vyavahara is something like a direction to which we are leading. It's like going in a tunnel and you are seeing the light at the end of the tunnel already. There are no exits in the tunnel. There's a sure way of reaching the exit if you only keep moving on. So nechannapi muchyate is another expression that I have used in the past. Therefore, it is not just a maili gallu, but you're going far ahead. Why do you say I'm saying that you have come far ahead? You know, in Viveka Chudamani, it says jantunam narajanma durlabham. I'm talking to a human being here. Narajanma durlabham means what? With a lot of bank balance of punya, you have attained this. For what? For attaining sakshatkara. That means here in this birth, you can attain sakshatkara. That is what Ishvara is saying. Therefore, make the best out of it. Don't get the hindrance saying, papoham, papakarmoham, papatma, papasambhavaha. Instead of that, you say, aham brahmasmi. Yo hamasmi brahma hamasmi ahamasmi brahma hamasmi, like ahameva aham manjuho miswaha. In that pratismaraniya stotra, what is it that you have to remember instead of constantly living in the gutter saying that I'm going back in time? You have to say in the eka shloki, kim jyotistava bhanumana harime, finally jyotistadasmi prabho. Even if you don't have jnana sakshatkara, do that as a part of upasana. It will help you a long way. That is my direction.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Of course, there is no, as I just finished my Viveka Chudamani class, tat chintanam, tat kathanam, anyonyam, tat prabodhanam, ekaparatvancha, brahma bhyasam vidur budhaha. So, asuktehe amrtehe kalam, nayed vedanta chintaya. That is one sure short way, being focused on that act. Next question.
That's it, sir. Thank you. Thank you all the patrons for tuning in. Hope Sri Simhaji has given a path for all the seekers. Thank you, everybody.
Namaskaram, dhanyavadah, yatkritam, yatkarishyami, tatsarvam, namayakritam, twayakritam, tuphalabhuk, tvameva, madhusudana, Sri Sadguru Charanaravindarpanamastu, Om Tat Sat. Namaste.